uncopyrighted music.
Oh, it is?
Yes.
You sure?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of my dad trying out something different, American Truck Simulator. So go ahead and just hit drive. And there you are. So first, in cab mode, I got another keyboard here, make it easier to reach buttons. Just press 1 on it. And there you go. And use the mouse to look around. Kind of... Now start the engine, you want to press this button right here on the steering wheel. There you go. Now you have it in neutral right now, so...
Yeah. Do I have lights?
Yeah, you have lights right here, this top button. Wait, no, I got reverse. Okay, it's the bottom. I got so many different games that... This one right here. Oh, you just need to cut the trailer. There you go. That bomb button right there should be lights. There you go. Our windshield wipers on. Nope. There you go. They're off now. Gosh, I gotta change that. I got so many different games up there. Okay. Should be good. I'm gonna go right. Yeah, last time you tried this, you had a little trouble getting out. Now, if you hold down, key stop it for a second. I just remember something. I'm just gonna hit escape. I'm gonna borrow this. I forgot to assign a button because I don't play American Truck Simulator because they don't give it a lot of updates. They need a little more updates in it. Let's see, where's the zoom button? Zoom interior camera. There you go. I got it. Okay, here you go. So, now you can use the mouse if you want. And if there's a button on the side, on the left side of the mouse, if you feel your thumb. And if you press it, you can actually zoom. Like, it'll zoom the camera if you need to look at your rearview mirror on your right side. If you can't see it very well, when you're backing up or whatever. So if you look, you won't follow red lines, so when you get out of the store area, you want to turn right. Not now, but... going down a hill, if you look at your, you press F and that turns on your flashers. You don't worry about the AI smashing the back of your trailer. Because they like to do that. Wonderful AI. Driving on the actual game, I do something called Truckers Multiplayer, where it's like a multiplayer version of this, which I might have you try out another day. It's a lot harder than this, because unlike the AI, which is somewhat predictable, you don't know what the actual person is in. You got some crazy people to drive. It cost me about $50,000 of damage in the truck so far.
Speed a second ago and it was red, you get fined for that? Or?
Yeah, you got fined immediately.
Oh man.
It's not much. I have 74,000, I'm not worried about that.
Oh, hammer down.
Yeah, hammer down.
What if I crash the truck?
You actually do get, if you crash enough, it won't start, you'll ruin the transmission. If you totaled 100% on both the trailer and the truck, I'd be.
Well, you know how it gets.
Now, up ahead, you need to turn left because the road actually is kind of blocked off straight ahead. Like the AI, can go through it, but you can't, because ahead is the freeway. You want to turn left up here at this first place. Right here. Actually, no, you want to go straight. I don't know. The map glitched. Just go straight. I don't know why I'm used to driving a truck simulator. Okay, now you want to turn left. That makes more sense. Best with a steering set, like pedals, and steering wheel called G20. clutch and the gear shift, it cost about, I don't know, around $300. Yeah. But it comes with an actual, like, truck shifter. You know, H shifter, right? A lot of people say that American Truck Simulator is actually dying because they're not getting enough updates, because this game was released a while ago. So far they only have three states. Oh, you want to get off right here. You just missed your exit. You can go straight. It'll work too. The map will change it in a sec. It'll tell you to go straight. Just keep going straight. That was just backwards, but oh, it's making you go left. This map is the weirdest thing ever. Like, if you're not paying attention, I'll have you get off an exit and get right back on the highway, because it doesn't count. Like, the GPS only counts distance, not, it doesn't account for speed limits. It's like, okay, you can say 3 seconds going this way, but you have to be still going 75. No, but you can keep going straight, actually, because I'll tell you when to turn right. You can actually turn right, it'll loop around back to reverse, just instead of going backwards. I can reroute you to go along the highway, so it's not too confusing. See, yeah, see.
Very swing a U-turn.
See, you missed your exit here. It's trying to make you turn around, and go back
I
that way.
I was getting ready to.
You can actually just go this way.
Okay.
Still pretty interesting drive. Here you go. Sponsored by Memory Foam Mattresses. Oh, that's why you don't text while driving, kids.
Now
you're gonna have to back up. See, that was just proof why you don't do that. You look down for him for a second, he goes flying off the highway. Then again, it was a game, so it's not really the same, but... Yeah. You're stuck. Just set it down. There we go. Just kind of go straight out and you'll be fine. Like I was saying earlier, people say this game's dying because they only got three states. They got California, Nevada, and Arizona currently. Now they make mods for the whole country, but it's not really the same. They said next they're going to do New Mexico, so I don't know what their plan are. After New Mexico, they're going to go to Texas or go ahead north or what. Up ahead, you want to go right. Yeah, he just slammed on his brakes. Now, if that was an actual player that did that, he would probably start typing the chat, yelling at you and stuff, calling you idiot.
Cyberbullying?
Yeah, probably. Happened to me earlier today. It wasn't even my fault. I looked down and I kind of went over in the lane. I wasn't even near the guy, and the guy just types idiot. So I take my feet and just slam on the brakes. You know, that was too smart.
Yeah, that's what I did in reverse and pushing back.
Yeah, I did that, and then he got a little mad at me, and I just kind of took a little detour around the road.
Me too.
Because it's at like 50% damage, and there's a big red light saying you need to go get a repair. Don't you love the color of truck? A bright green? Like, I don't know who picked this color truck. But it's just.
You should still run 80 then.
Yeah. Thing like you get more XP if you do park it yourself, and it's more fun. It's that the bomb ones are for people who don't know what they're doing.
I don't know what I'm doing.
You do. You're doing great. You only got 30% damage.
Considering I was doing 90 on the
road. You're doing pretty good handling.
I'm good.
You want to just pull forward. You'll see it. It's like it's a highlighted white line. You'll see it. look there. You have to back it up there. To that little area. Yeah, you gotta back it up there. That's where the zoom button, like, if you take your thumb out, if you feel a button, but press it, you can actually zoom in. Yeah, this is a pretty easy drop-off. I was kinda hoping they'd give you the store drop-off. I just... Store drop-off is literally the worst. I will make it easier for you if you want to. If you press 2, you'll get out of the cab view. It'll make it easier for you, but I'll give you more credit on it. Mental
press
credit.
What?
2. Like the key 2. It'll make you get in this view. Or either way. Or if you just want to look and see where you are at. They have a lot of different views on this. You're neutral. You're still neutral. Where's that? There you go now. Or not.
Yeah.
also have your truck malfunctioning. XP.
Oh, man. I tried.
You did pretty good.
I tried.
Alright. So what do you think of the game?
Pretty cool. A little glitchy. Hard to control, but...
Yeah, that's not really a game. It's the steering wheel.
Yeah.
Well, there you go, guys.